Do you know, guys, that your G Suite admin can read your emails? Is it possible that someone can read your emails without letting you know? Yes, guys, it is possible that G Suite admin can get a BCC copy of all your emails which you have sent or received through your G Suite account. And interestingly, G Suite admin can do this without knowing your account password. So today I'm going to share with you that what are the various things that a G Suite admin knows about you if you are using a G Suite account of your company or your institution. So let's find out. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Malkeet Singh Academy. My name is Jaskirat. Hope you are doing well. Yes guys, it is true. If you are using a G Suite account of your organization, then there is 101% chances that your Google Workspace admin can read your emails without letting you know or without changing your password. But you can consider yourself lucky if your organization is using a free version of G Suite, like free G Suite for Education account. So in that case, this feature to read emails is not available. But if your organization is using a paid account like Google Workspace Basic, Business, Government, Education, or Enterprise Edition, then this feature is available. So how an admin can read your emails? Well, the thing is, guys, that Google allows Google Workspace admins to monitor and audit users' emails. A G Suite admin has so many things in which he can use in the admin panel. Things like admin can use Google Wallet, can use content compliance rules, also do the audit API or email delegation to view and audit users' emails. So auditing emails can be easily achieved by doing certain settings by the admin in the admin panel. So as you can see on the screen, some of the steps that an admin can perform by doing all these changes in the admin panel, an admin can have the access to your emails. After the implementation of these settings, admin will start receiving a BCC copy of user's email in his mailbox. And users are not even aware of that secretly admin is having a BCC copy of all the emails that a user sent or received. So make sure that you are using your account for a good purpose. But guys, in real life, it is not the thing that admin can read your emails without considering the local laws of a country. So it is recommended for Google Workspace admins to consider their country's law before performing emails auditing on their users' mailboxes. Because in some countries, employees' consent is must before performing auditing on the users' mailboxes. Now coming to the next things, what else can an admin know about you? Do you know, in G Suite, admin knows about your brand of which operating system does your mobile phone have? Pretty cool feature for an admin, I think. So here guys, I'm sharing G Suite admin panel. So these are all the tabs you can see. So if I click here on the device tab, it will open a new window, and here you can see open for mobile devices. If I click here, it will show the complete list of devices. Here you can see device name, name of the user email, and their operating system like Android or Apple, and there is a ownership and when did the user do his first sync, means when did he or she sign in through their company email ID. And last we have last sync, which means when did the user last sync with her or G Suite account. So that's pretty great details. So it's like you can't say that, look boss, my iPhone is not working and I have software issues in my phone. So admin will look up here and knows about your mobile and he will find out that you are using Android phone. So guys, lame excuses doesn't work in G Suite, you know. Now coming to the next part, as all of the admin panels like Microsoft Teams or Zoom, etc., G Suite Admin Center has a feature to store detailed reports of every account. So if I click here on the report tab, here you can see a new window will open up. First, it has all the highlights reports in which it shows the highlights like what's the status of different accounts, active or suspend or blocked. Here you can see, and there are 00 users in both suspended and archived. Next is the storage being used. So here you can see 5.24 GB out of 100 TB, And you know guys, signing up for G Suite, you will get 100 TB pool storage. So it's very good storage for a company. So coming to next option, this option is about how many files have been shared externally. So here externally means that outside the organization. So it is here according to the month wise. So if I click on the view details, it will give me more details about that. Next one is what's the user activity in different apps. So here you can see all the tabs like Gmail, Drive, Hangout, Calendar, Classroom. By clicking on any of the tab, I can see the details of every user month wise. Similarly for the Drive, all the details could be seen here month wise, and similarly all the other reports like Meet, Hangout, Calendar, Classroom. At last we have the user's report. So if I click here on the user's report and click on the app's uses, it will open a new window here, you can see. Now here you can see the individual report of the storage uses of different users, like how many GB or MB used by a particular user. Here you can see the different tabs like Gmail storage, Drive storage, photo storage and total storage in MBs. And the admin can easily filter out the user who are using the storage for Gmail or Drive, or using the company storage to save their personal photos. So guys, you can see there are so many things that an admin can see about you or know about your activities in G Suite. So use your company G Suite account very carefully. So don't save any personal photographs on your G Suite account, because admin can have also access to the Google Vault, which stores all the images in that. Even if you have deleted your pictures from your own Drive, pictures will be accessible to the admin through Google Vault. So very careful while you are storing your personal images on your company's G Suite account. So if you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I regularly make these kind of videos. So thanks a lot for watching this video. See you soon guys. Bye bye.